So now good evening to all. Today we see part 5 under complex number. In the last class we have seen after part 4 solving that is finding the value of x and y. So today we are going to see fourth the third question we are going to see. Third or fourth? So third only. Here x square plus root of x square plus 3x plus 8 x plus 4i. Here x plus 4i and this is equal to y bracket 2 plus i. So y bracket 2 plus i. If in the root varunala we take this term to the right hand side. So root of x square plus 3x plus 8 is equal to y bracket 2 plus i minus of x plus 4 plus i. Now take y inside. So 2y plus yi minus x minus 4i. Now correct the real part and imaginary part. So 2y without i real part with i imaginary part. Take I common. So y minus x minus 4. This side we are having root of x square plus 3x plus 8. Now equating real part and imaginary part on both sides. It is a complete real part because no I at all. Then imaginary part is not another. We can write just I 0. This is imaginary part, no imaginary part. So you write just I 0. So real part is x square plus 3x plus 8. We are equating a real part equal to inductive real part is 2y and equating imaginary part. So equate imaginary part. Here imaginary part is 0 and the side imaginary part y minus x minus 4 equal to 0 which implies y equal to x plus 4. Here 2 unknowns is it. So if we find 2 unknowns means we replace y by x plus 4. So substitute the value of y equal to x plus 4 in this equation. So we write it as x square plus 3x plus 8 equal to 2 bracket x plus 4. Now take 2 inside. So 2x plus 8. This side you get x square plus 3x plus 8. But in your root is the root form number. So this is you are writing root. Now you just make the expansion of this. Take the square root on both sides. That is square on both sides. Appa and in the square number, you have root in your cancel. So x square plus 3x plus 8 equal to here you write 2x plus 8 whole square. So this equal to 4x square plus we do 2 sub 4 32 x plus 64. So this side you write x square plus 3x plus 8. If I insert also in the side one of the minus side. So 4x square plus 32 x plus 64 right as it is. So minus x square minus 3x minus 8 equal to 0. So 4x square for us we get 3x square then plus 32 x minus here is get what? 3 x. What's the number? 3 x. So 29 here you write plus 29 x plus 32 minus 3 29 x then 64 minus 8 so 56. So this is equal to 0. So multiply panna what is it? 6 3 are 18 balance 1 5 is 168. If you add or subtract means 29. So for that you are getting 21 8 21 into 8 168 188 2 8 are 60. Then if you add you are getting 29. Then immediately you are writing by 3x by 3x. So if we cancel we get 7. So if you back range you are getting x plus 7, then 3x plus 8. So this is equal to 0. So which implies x equal to minus 7 or x equal to minus 8 by 3. So when the x value is equal, immediately you are finding 2 y values. So now when x is equal to, you substitute, when x equal to minus 7, here y is equal to, you will substitute for it. So y is equal to x plus 4 is equal to, in the place for x, x you are writing minus 7 plus 4, so this is equal to minus 3. So y is equal to minus 3. So one set of solution, when x equal to minus 7, y equal to minus 3. And the other set of solution, here is a substitute function. So in the y equal to x plus 4, for x you are writing minus 8 by 3 plus 4. You cross multiply, so you get minus 8 plus 12 by 3, isn't it? So you are getting 4 by 3. So this is equal to 4 by 3. Therefore the solution is when x equal to minus 8 by 3, y value is minus 4 by 3. We will check the answer for this. Minus 8 by 3, 4 by 3, minus 7, minus 3. So this answer is correct. So this is very very important, sir. We are finding the value of x and y. For that, in the root of the pasatala, so in the term, you bring it to the right hand side. You make the expansion. The government argument is the root is. So squaring on both sides and use a plus b whole square formula. Then in that way very easy only. Practice is in place. You are finding two values. So in the next class, you see the fourth term. That's it.